Harvard's 1989 national championship season may have ended here, but it really began when Coach Bill Cleary, at the outset of the season, handed the goaltending chores to two freshmen. Cleary put the fate of his talent-laden team in the glove hands of Alain Roy and Chucky Hughes, a couple of untested rookies who led the Crimson to hockey's ultimate prize. Every year, more and more freshmen are making major contributions like Roy and Hughes, and this year's Beanpot is loaded with first-year phenoms. The adjustment from high school hockey to the college game is profound, and most freshmen talk of one major change.
Faster. Definitely faster.
Speed of the game.
College is faster. Definitely faster.
Speed. Speed would be the big key.
The key for Bobby Kellogg, Northeastern's outstanding defenseman from Springfield, is to make progress each game, because he has the big shot and the prototype blue liner's build to become one of the Huskies' best ever. He's that good. Harvard's young trio of Matt Mulgrave, Ted Drury, and Stephen Flomenhoff all began the year slowly, but have started to shine in the second half of the season. Mulgrave and Flomenhoff have been skating together on the same line, while Drury is a world-class forward with exceptional stick-handling skills. Boston College has again landed a bumper crop of young talent led by Wilbraham's Bill Guerin. A big, aggressive forward, Guerin is a young Cam Neely type who was chosen fifth overall in last year's NHL draft. Defenseman Teddy Crowley is having a steady initial campaign on the BC Blue Line, while goalie Scott LeGrand, enjoying an outstanding year, feels that Hughes and Roy paved the way for freshman netminders.
I think, once what Chucky and Al did really made it a lot easier for some of the other freshmen to come in and do the job.
The top freshman class in the Beanpot, and probably the nation, belongs to Boston University, which has gone with 9 rookies all season. They're led by forward Tony Amonte, an impact player out of their academy, who, according to coach Jack Parker, is much more than a terrific hockey player.
The thing that surprised me most is that Tony Amonte is not only everything he was supposed to be as far as what you saw on the ice, but he's much more than that in the dressing room. He's much more than that at practice. He's a terrific competitor. He's a terrific team man. He's concerned about how his teammates feel about him and how they feel about themselves.
Goalie Scott Cashman was supposed to be good, but he's been nothing short of phenomenal. He's been the league's best netminder and, says Parker, the Terriers' MVP. Peter Ahola, a 6'3 defenseman from Finland, has emerged as one of Hockey East's best blue liners, bringing stability to BU's back line after the loss of injured Tom Dion. As Harvard and Boston University square off in tonight's Beanpot Final in front of 14,000-plus spectators at the Boston Garden, visions of the National Hockey League invariably pop into the players' minds. With most of the top freshmen having already been drafted by NHL teams, it becomes increasingly difficult to keep players in school for 4 years. Jack Parker speaks for all the coaches when he talks of the lure of the pros.
There's a lot of good reasons to stay in college other than getting the degree. But in our mind, getting the degree is obviously the best one. We try to impress upon our guys that very seldom, if ever, have we heard of a guy who left too late. We've heard of a lot of guys who have left too early.
And Parker's talented freshman and his club have a 3-0 lead after the first period of play in the 1990 Beanpot Championship. When we come back, Sean and Bob will recap tonight's first period of play. As we go to a break, Bruins scout Joe Lyons talks about freshmen and the Beanpot.
I think this is a great class coming up this year. These freshmen are going to be exciting. This should be a tremendous Beanpot, talent-wise and aggressiveness. I think it'll really be good.